Okay, so today we have Garbage and Only Happy When It Rains. Love the band name. I've heard of them, but I don't think I've ever heard a song by them. So we're going to get into this one today, which is, I guess, one of their most known. So when a request came in for this band, I was just like, I want to see what they're about. And anyway, I'm still kind of sick here. If you can't tell, my voice is still struggling, but I just had to say it again because it's kind of, I would think, noticeable. Anyway, let's get into this, talk about it after. And I still wanted to listen to Garbage, so here we go.
I'm only happy when it rains.
Okay, so that's Garbage and Only Happy When It Rains. Again, maybe I just, the word garbage is one of my favorite words. I just love that they're named Garbage. But anyway, what a good song. Holy crap. Off the bat, Shirley Manson, who is the lead singer here that I've just found out, great, just great vocals. And honestly, I liked how I mean, I guess it wasn't like a cappella, but like when the song started off, it was kind of just more her voice, and then the band, I was gonna say the band, but then the, you know, instruments or whatever came in, and yeah, and then there's another part in there which it kind of happened again. But anyway, her voice was just very clear, you know, crisp. And I love the whole message of the tune as well, because, you know, just that whole thing of kind of like, I'm depressed and I don't care, you know, and which is something, I mean, that I don't think people talk about enough or whatever. It's just like when you're that kind of, you're in that mood, maybe people talk about it. But anyway, I like that they're talking about it here. And, you know, just the chorus, obviously, with, you know, pour your misery down on me. It's just like talking about, I'm miserable and I don't care. You know, this kind of a thing is what I'm getting. And talking about, you know, I'm only happy when it rains. And what she said, you know, I love it when the news is bad and why it feels so good to feel so sad. So it's just like, this track is just like dark, I guess you could say. And yeah, I enjoyed it. It was just, it was very enjoyable. And just the whole thing, because this is a mood, you know, I'm only happy when it rains. And I just love it a lot. And the guitar work in this was phenomenal as well. I mean, there's like a sputtering guitar at some point. And it was just like, yeah, I was just taken aback by the musicianship, I guess you could say. And because, yeah, again, I love Shirley's voice. Shirley's voice. I felt like I said that weird. But anyway, but the musicians in this, I mean, well, including Shirley, just like very, very good. Second to none here. I was just like, everything was just very good. You know, it was not garbage at all. All right. So yeah. And I am on Genius again on the About, like I usually do. So just to read, you know, more about the song here for myself. And maybe if you don't know either. So yeah. Anyway, it says one of the most recognizable songs by Garbage. It was released as the second single to promote Garbage's self-titled album in the UK. The song was written somewhat in a spur of the moment when the band was sitting around playing acoustic guitars. It started with the line, I'm only happy when it rains, and was built around the opening lyric. Lyrically, it's a tongue-in-cheek take on gloomy lyrics of earlier 90s rock songs. Butch Vig said, and I also did see this, Butch Vig, who plays drums on the track, which I was like, is that the Butch Vig, you know, producer, you know, Nirvana, Nevermind guy? And yeah, so I didn't know that he was on, you know, in Garbage, but apparently he kind of started the whole thing. So yeah, I was just, whoa, Butch Vig, my goodness. All right. Anyway, Butch Vig said, Only Happy When It Rains was about what happened with the grunge and the angst-filled thing, which has dominated the American alternative rock scene. I mean, yeah, he was a big part of, you know, grunge. With us, there's self-deprecation. We have to poke fun at ourselves because we're so incredibly obsessive about the songs and the lyrics, which makes us filled with self-loathing. Her. Anyway, it goes on. The song was, you know, covered by many artists. What else did we got? And that's basically it for the genius.com about there. But yeah, again, I guess, you know, kind of the whole thing, you know, pour your misery down on me. I guess it's like I said, it's like a mood, but also if they're being tongue in cheek here, it's just like, you know, poking fun at, you know, a lot of bands that are always serious about this stuff. Like, I guess a lot of bands that tackle, you know, dark subject matter all the time, and it's like always just kind of sad. So yeah, I like that they kind of, they were poking fun as well. I like that. Anyway, also there are some annotations in the song, but I'm not going to read all of them because I don't want to be here too long. But with the chorus, you know, pour your misery down on me, it says, this kind of sad makes me happy attitude is very prevalent in Shirley Manson's homeland, which is Scotland. This could also be a reference to the metaphorical use of the terms pour and rain. So yeah, you know, pour and rain, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, I don't know why it's in blah, blah, blah so much, but anyway. And then, you know, talking about, again, just some more annotations here just to see, you know, talking about, you know, I love it when the news is bad and why it feels so good to be so sad. It says, as singer Shirley Manson put it, the song was a dig at ourselves because we like records that don't make us feel very happy. and at the so-called alternative scene of we're so weird and more wonderful than everybody else. So yeah, I like that as well. And then she also said in 2015, so we're jumping a bit here, but she also said it was definitely a little tongue-in-cheek and definitely ironic. Okay, so yeah, lots of irony going on here. I think we all felt as a band that alt-rock had gotten incredibly serious. So yeah, that's what I was kind of thinking, you know, all these bands were kind of very serious, and then Garbage came along and we're like, I mean, yeah, but we're not that serious about all this. A lot of bands that were copying the greats were becoming almost pompous in the, I love the word pompous, and the seriousness in which they approached music making. I think we all felt that it had gotten so dark and so bleak that it was almost funny. So I guess Only Happy When It Rains is a bit of a twist on our feelings towards where things were headed. So yeah, I just really love everything about this now because, talking about how, yeah, I mean, first of all, I mean, you have bands, if you just talk about the grunge era with Butch Vig, I mean, my God, I mean, you know, with his work with like Nirvana, obviously Kurt Cobain wrote some, you know, sad songs. Obviously, I mean, he wrote the song, you know, I Hate Myself, I Don't Want to Die, you know, that's not a very, that's kind of a bleak outlook on life. But then you have, you know, other grunge bands that come to mind. I mean, a lot of grunge bands, I think everybody, all of them, they talked about, you know, depression and death and suicide and everything. Especially like Alice in Chains, which is probably my favorite grunge band. I mean, Down in a Hole, I mean, that's very bleak as well, which is like my favorite AIC song. But yeah, it's just like, so, I mean, yeah, you had bands like that, but in like post-grunge, I guess, and just, you know, it's still in the 90s, you know, alt-rock bands, I can see, I mean, I wasn't there, obviously, but obviously some bands were like very, very serious, and it was just like very bleak, and it's just like that whole like Shirley said, you know, copying other bands, but they were just like not doing it, you know, justice kind of a thing is what I get from it. And so then finally Garbage was just like, well, let's just do this, Only Happy When It Rains. And I just love that they kind of went at, you know, all this kind of a stuff with, you know, that tongue-in-cheek kind of a thing. It was like, it's only I'm only happy when it rains. I'm always kind of a sad thing, but still there is some kind of truth in it, I guess, from what I see here as well, that, you know, they like to listen to records that make you sad. And I mean, I like that too. I mean, my goodness, a lot of bands out there make you sad. You know, bands that come to mind like Joy Division or artists like Nick Drake or Elliott Smith, kind of that dark music, but as well, you like it and it makes you kind of happy to be sad in a way. And again, just the whole thing of like, even though, you know, I know, it's, you know, like I said, you know, the whole tongue-in-cheek thing, you know, this is kind of like the whole thing of like, you're depressed, but you don't care. And even if you don't know anything about this song, that's what you might come away with it, which is still fine too, in my opinion. So yeah, I just, just really like, what they were doing here and their kind of their message. And, because again, after I listened to it, I didn't know that it was kind of like kind of being ironic. So yeah, I just like how, you know, how the two takeaways I got from this. So yeah, really enjoyed the track anyway. And it's cool that I didn't even know Butch Vig again. I didn't know that he was in a band or anything. And apparently, like, I see on his Wikipedia page here that he started the band. Basically he said, anyway, I guess just for one quote, he says, part of the reason why I started Garbage was by that time I had done Nevermind. I recorded, I swear to God, thousands of bands, and we were just guitar, bass, drums. And then he goes on, I was reading about all these other records that I was getting excited about, like Public Enemy, and going on. Afterwards, I hired a Scottish singer, Shirley Manson, and began composing together. So yeah, I guess he was just tired of that life, and he had to do something else. So there came Garbage. So yeah. Anyway, can't say enough good things about Garbage. Love the band name again. And yeah, anyway, so yeah, I guess that's all I got to say. Thanks for watching. Thanks for liking, subscribing, commenting. If you made it this far, sorry for my voice. You know, it's not the best, but I can't really hear very well. So I don't know if I'm yelling or what. But anyway, thanks for watching again. And I really love the message of the song. I thought it was just all kind of like everything is gloomy and that's okay. But come to find out, they were kind of being, you know, a little cheeky about it, which I think is funny. Anyway, thanks again for watching. I'll talk to you guys again.